Live from Gene Autry Way, welcome to Angel Stadium. MLB The Show with a good one coming at you. It's the New York Yankees and the Los Angeles Angels. First pitch coming your way next. Just about ready to roll. So here's the lefty, Patrick Sandoval. What do we have on him?
Well, he's got great stuff, but what makes his stuff even better is his delivery. Hides the ball for a very long time, high leg kick, and by the time the hitter sees it, it's right on top of him.
Okay, all set to go. Here's the left fielder, Isaiah Kiner-Falefa. The wind of the pitch. And that one is in the dirt. And we are underway. The lefty, the 1-0. Swing and a foul straight back. That one misses. Ball two. That to right. That takes care of Kiner-Falefa. And there's one down. As we take a look now at the New York Yankees lineup. This is a veteran-led lineup right here. A lot of players with plenty of experience, Singy.
Yeah, no doubt about that, Boog. These guys have been around the game for a long time, and they may not have the flash that they once did, but they've got the wisdom to be able to understand different situations, be able to think with the opponent and sometimes in front of the opponent. And you always seem to see a team like this. They come to the ballpark, they know how to get down to business, and they understand what the job is at hand.
Ball one there. Stanton, the guy capable of hitting it a long way.
Oh, you can tell how comfortable he is. Look at that front foot on the line as he is close to the plate, but he can be very quick to a pitch that is down and in.
Yeah. Next offering is in for a strike. He's a guy that's changed his stance over time. It's been a little more open, straight up, and now more closed.
One thing hitters will do, it's not so much about the stance, but it's what it does to the brain in terms of resetting and how they approach the pitcher.
And now it's 3-2.
Counts both.
The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Boog, if I were him, I'd be nibbling around the plate as well. I mean, this guy is just capable of hitting pitches outside of the zone and driving them a long way.
Gleyber Torres up to hit. In there, and it's 0-1.
0-1.
Late swing, fouled off. Oh, and two now. Keeps the at bat going with a foul ball. The pitch gets a piece, and it stays 0-2. And that one almost got him.
Straighten him up a little bit.
Next pitch is popped up. Rengifo under it. And there are two down.
Boy, that was a hanging breaking ball right there. I think he tried to do a little bit too much. Sometimes those eyes can get really big. I think his swing broke down as well, and that's what caused him to pop it up.
Anthony Rizzo steps to the plate.
Over there.
ball
no,
one.
That's out.
On the ground, right side, and foul ball. Left-hand hitter waits. Rips that one to right. Renfro makes the catch, and that'll do it. Nothing across on no hits, no errors, and one man left. And now the Angels will get their first opportunity in this one. No score. Back in Anaheim, and going to the mound in this one for the Yankees, Domingo Germán.
Try to stay back for that power changeup. Speed differential between the fastball and the changeup is huge. Hitters, they have a hard time staying back.
Here's the center fielder, Mickey Moniak. And a pitch. That's a little bit low. Righty delivers.
Ball, that's up.
Now 3-0. And now 3-1.
Clearly taking all the way there in that 3-0 count. It was a cookie right down the middle.
And a 3-1 on the way. That one is absolutely belted. Bader going back. Back some more. Back some more. Hauls it in on the warning track. Take a look at the lineup. And here is Taylor Ward. And a good fastball to start him off. That's strike one. Swing and a bouncer. Torres fires over to first. Here tonight, an efficient start to the home first, two away.
Batting third, the designated hitter.
Two outs, bases empty. Here's Shohei Ohtani. He's a guy who does it all. With the lack of contact in today's game, this guy hits for contact, so he delivers average, but there's on base and slugging too. That one's in there, 0-1.
Early in the count, you have to be real careful because of that power, but then if this hitter gets a strike or two on him, he's still very comfortable, and because he has the ability to get the barrel to the baseball, he's a threat deep into the count as well.
Started to go after it. Now we'll look down to third, and Eric Summersgill punches him out. That's a strikeout. Angels go down 1-2-3. We played an inning. No score. Welcome back. DJ LeMahieu will get things going.
The third baseman, DJ LeMahieu.
The pitch. Now a screamer into the outfield. Into the dive, and he got it. And wow, what a great diving catch, Singy. StatCast says that was a near perfect route, and it had to be.
That's just a big part of his game. I mean, this guy's instincts just seem to always put him in a position to make special plays, and right there, he's done it again.
And now Bader up to the plate. First pitch, and it just misses.
1-0.
Second inning here, no score. And now the lefty. That misses. Two balls and a strike. And he drops it down the third baseline. And it goes just foul. 2-2 down. Dives and he can't hang on. No throw, and they can't get the out.
Couldn't have timed it up any better than that. That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you've got to make them pay. And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
Runner on at first with one gone, and now it's going to be Billy McKinney. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Kicks and deals. On a line out towards center. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there are two outs. Here's Jose Trevino. This guy, one of the best defensive catchers going. You talk about framing, the ability to block, catch, and throw. He is at the top of the game. That one ran inside. Almost got him.
Really good athlete, and many times we talk about, you know, the feet of infielders. This catcher as well, really quick feet. He's able to recognize the pitch, see the trajectory, and get into a spot where he can block those balls and keep them from going to the backstop.
Let's go, Andrew. Shot back to the mound, and he gloves it. On to first. That's out number three. So no runs here and a base hit. No errors and one left. Now to the bottom of the second. We're tied. Nothing. Bottom of the inning. And here's the veteran outfielder, Hunter Renfro.
The right fielder.
Really impressive with the way he frames, the way that he sets it up, because sometimes those pitches are off the plate. But because he sets up and presents it so well, he steals strikes for his pitcher.
Why to kick the pitch? He swings and fouls one off. And the righty deals. Swing and a miss. And the count, 1-2. Can't connect on the curveball, struck him out.
Well, when you swing through that one breaking ball that puts you up against the ropes with two strikes, you think he's either going to double up or try to blow a fastball by you at the next pitch. And right there, he snapped off another curve, and it was the same result as the pitch before.
Here's Mike Moustakas to hit. Next offering, pop foul off to the right out of play. Mike Moustakas, known as Moose, he's the second overall pick in the 2007 draft. Righty to the plate. Tapper back to the mound. Throw on to Rizzo, and a couple of quick outs.
Batting six. The catcher.
Matt Theis comes up to hit here.
This lineup's going to have to find a way to make him work a little harder out there on the mound. I mean, he is just mowing them down. He's settling in. You got to make him uncomfortable. Maybe step out of the box, call timeout, do whatever it takes.
Foul ball there. Two down, nobody on. And that's outside. Ball. Next offering misses down and away. And a pitch. To the right side. Has some trouble with it. The throw is still in time. And they do get the out. Angels go quietly there. We'll move to the third with no score. Back here at Angel Stadium. Well, here we go. Top of the third, scoreless game. And stepping in for the Yankees, Anthony Volpe. The wind of the pitch. Swing and a ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit.
Didn't take long to get a result for that at bat. Just kept it simple. Played pepper with the middle of the infield and took it back where it came from, and there's just no one there to knock it down. And now a chance to maybe get creative on offense with good speed on first.
Back to the top of the lineup. Isaiah Kiner-Falefa gets the bunt down the right side. Goes to second for one. Not in time at first. It's a fielder's choice.
Well, that was going to be a really tough one to turn two on. So a nice job to get the out at second right there. Hold on to the baseball. Shortstop clearly paid the price, but that kind of comes with the territory.
And here is Giancarlo Stanton. Outfield playing very deep, not wanting anything over their heads. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Singy, we think of Giancarlo Stanton with the big-time power as a baseball player, but he was actually recruited to play football at USC. Flares it into the outfield. He's got it, and there's two away.
Now back. Second base.
Here's Gleyber Torres. He popped out his first time. Torres, multi-time All-Star, 26 years old, and he was born in Venezuela. To first, and they've got him picked off. The tag, and that's out number three, inning over. Home half of the third coming up, no score. As we go and to the last of the third, Angels. Eduardo Escobar, El Caballo up to him.
Escobar.
Herman back to work.
One ball, no strike.
And he deals. Swing and a foul straight back.
Pretty good pitch there to take a rip at. He wants to get his arms extended. He likes the ball away from him a little bit. Just not able to square it up.
That misses.
That's the ball.
And it's 2-1.
2-1.
The wind and the pitch. That's to third. Fires across the diamond. Escobar out of the play.
Pattinger, the second baseman.
Luis Rengifo, the next to hit for the Angels. He has consistently been one of the best in the sport against lefties, and yet the righties give him trouble. You know, you don't want to be labeled as that guy, but the numbers say what they say.
That missed, that's the ball.
And the first pitch misses for ball one.
Oh, he's a good player, but if he wants to be great, he's going to have to figure it out against right-handed pitchers. There's so many right-handers in the game that you're going to see them one after another. So you would imagine with that many looks, Boog, that the adjustment's got to be coming soon.
And the pitch. Swing and a foul over the screen and back out of play. Kicks and fires. And a swing and a miss.
It's a good changeup to hit up in the zone. I don't think he recognized it. I'm sure he'd love to have that one back.
One down, base is empty. That's hard hit on the line. Bader makes a nice grab at a full sprint.
Batting up. That's your stop.
Here's David Fletcher.
Fletcher.
Fletcher, in his fifth season, hitting ninth in today's lineup. And he was a sixth-round draft pick back in 2015. Just off the outside edge, 1-0. The pitch.
No, that's inside.
That misses.
No, that misses.
And now 3-0. The corner for a strike. And there's ball
That's
four.
Ball four. Runner takes your base.
One of the things about that two-out walk, the base runner over at first base is going to have a very aggressive secondary lead. So a ball down the line or into the gap will produce a two-out RBI, and those are the best. That is, if you are the offensive side of it.
On the ground, right side. Slings to first. Play made. That ends the inning. Angels strand one, and we are still scoreless. Back here at the ballpark, John Ciampi with Chris Singleton, and set to lead off the fourth, Gleyber Torres. Here comes a pitch. Good eye right there. Torres, a guy the Yankees acquired for Aroldis Chapman back in 2016.
He is fearless. You can't tell if he's been in this league for 8 years or 2 years.
Next pitch is outside.
Back-to-back breaking pitches away, you get the feeling as a hitter that the pitcher's afraid of you, that he doesn't want to challenge you. So I think the confidence level is raised right here.
Next offering is fouled back. And the 3-1. Swing and a liner foul off to the right. We'll see another payoff pitch. The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. Out to short. And that squirts through. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
Love how he became a really tough out with two strikes right there. Breaking ball was in a decent spot down and in, but he did a really nice job getting to it before it tied him up.
And here is Anthony Rizzo. He's 0-for-1. Ball one, no strikes. Runner at first with no outs here. That's in there. That's strike one.
Generally, second, third time through the lineup, you want to be able to lean on those secondary pitches and command them. Looks like
runner on the go. Swing and a miss. Throw. Save.
Good steal of second right there. And now the table is set for the middle of this order to drive in the first run of this ball game. I like that they're trying to manufacture some offense early on.
No No outs, runner on second. And that one lifted in the air center field. Rizzo out of the play. Grounder tags at second. And he's in safely at third with one out.
Now back the third baseman, DJ LeMahieu.
And now it's DJ LeMahieu digging in.
And remember, he was absolutely robbed of a base hit last time up.
Swings through that one. 0-1.
He's pitching well, but not throwing a ton of first pitch strikes. Usually doesn't work out for success, but you can never predict baseball.
One away with a runner at third. Next pitch is outside.
Flew open a little bit with that front shoulder, but was able to slow his back down just enough to make contact with that pitch. Keep the at-bat alive.
Here's a 1-2. And he grounds one back up the middle. Dives, but it's off his glove. He doesn't have a throw, and they get a run at home.
Puts a run on the board and picks up an RBI. Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. The ones in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it.
Now it's going to be Harrison Bader. First offering misses the mark. That one missed.
Well, with the amount of pitches that can end up in the dirt, a good secondary lead doesn't have to get away from the catcher, but if you're anticipating based off the trajectory, get yourself into scoring position.
And a four-pitch walk.
Well, interesting. He went with the off-speed and walked the hitter. Man, you got to challenge the guy with the fastball.
So first and second with one man gone. Here's Billy McKinney at the plate.
At the dish, looking to lift the ball in the air in this spot. Anything but the inning double play, Boog.
Yeah, the lefty with the 0-1.
Two pretty nasty sliders to get this hitter in an 0-2 count. If you're up there at the plate, you got to look up in the zone and spit on anything that's down.
Oh, and two now. Fights it off. He'll see another. One out. Runners at first and second. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Slider got him for strike three.
Well, when you throw the same pitch back to back, that's how you want to do it. Set him up in the strike zone, then extend a little bit from there and see if you can get him to chase. Nicely done with the slider right there.
Jose Trevino will hit next. 0-1, he grounded out in his first at bat. Foul ball. That misses the zone, and it's a ball and a strike. Laser, base hit. Around third comes LeMahieu. He'll score easily. It's 2-0.
Well, he gets it done in a big spot to get the run across. Off the bat, that one registered at 105 miles per hour, man. That is smoking, and these days you hear it all the time, but the numbers just don't lie. If you can drive a ball like that, more often than not, you're picking up a knock.
Here's the shortstop at the plate. Anthony Volpe in there at the knees. Strike one. Two outs, couple of base runners at first and second. And takes low for ball one. That one drilled left field. And it's gone! A big blow to the home fans, and they tack on three. It's 5-0.
Change up in the zone is a hitter's dream. It's a BP fastball, but you're playing in real time. Most times, the pitcher's asking for a new baseball, just like right there.
Isaiah Kiner-Falefa up to the plate. And that's in there for strike one.
No ball, one strike.
And he takes a strike. Activity in the bullpen. No ball, Tucker strike. Davidson, the left-hander, up and throwing. Number 59, the right-hander, also getting loose. Next one in the dirt.
Clearly, he hasn't had it in this game, and looks like sooner than later, they're going to have to go to the bullpen.
Pitch misses there. Two balls, two strikes to count with two outs. And now it's filled up. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. Payoff pitch. Fouled off the plate. They'll do it again. Three, two. Popped up. Moose has a beat on it. Puts the squeeze on it. And that is the third out of the inning. But not before five cross the plate, with a big blow being this three-run homer. And the lead is now 5-0. It's Major League Baseball on the show. And welcome back. Bottom of the fourth. So in now for the Angels, Taylor Ward. And a pitch. And there's a curve through for a strike.
0-1.
Here comes the 0-1. And fouled off. And the right-hander deals. Swing and a pop-up in foul ground. LeMahieu in position. Makes the grab, one down.
Now back, the designated hitter, Shohei Ohtani.
Shohei Ohtani up to the dish. He struck out swinging at his first at-bat. Just missed.
This is a very important inning here. After scoring all those runs, you want your pitcher to come out and just mow them down. The offense has worked hard. It's shut down inning time.
And the 1-0. That clips the corner.
Let's see if he's willing to use the whole field right here. Definitely pounding him away.
Next one misses, and it's 2-1.
2-1.
Hit hard. That gets through.
Just so sound in his mechanics. Hits against a firm front side. And the hands just continue to carry through the middle of the field.
Now it's Hunter Renfroe. He was a strikeout victim his first time. That pitch in for a strike, and it's 0-1.
He's pitching well, but not throwing a ton of first-pitch strikes. Usually doesn't work out for success, but you can never predict baseball.
Pickoff throw, Ohtani back in. Ball and one now.
Ball.
Runner on the goal. Ball misses. Throw to second. Great jump.
You don't usually see teams try to claw back into games by being aggressive on the base pass like this, but it's still early in this one. This kind of tells me they're going to try to tackle this one run at a time instead of waiting back for a big three-run homer.
One now. Ripped to the right center. Base hit. And that's going to roll to the wall. The throw into second. He pulls into second. A run comes in on the play.
Well, it was a great job of letting that runner steal second base, get into scoring position, come through with the base knock. You add a run.
First baseman, Mike Moustakas. 0 for 1 so far. In there for strike one. And a swing and a miss there.
I think he was sitting off speed there.
Right-hander kicks, deals. Volpe throws it to first in time, and he's out.
Now batting, catcher, Matt Theis.
Matt Theis, the next to hit for the Angels. In there, and it's 0-1. Hot shot to third. LeMahieu gets it to first. Inning over, and it could have been worse. So they pick up a run on two hits, no errors, and a man left. We played four. It's the Yankees 5, and the Angels 1. They hand the ball over to a new arm, Tucker Davidson. Now here's Giancarlo Stanton. Giancarlo Stanton, who won the National League MVP in 2017 and then was traded immediately to the New York Yankees.
Yeah, the last two players to win the MVP and then be traded were both traded to the New York Yankees. Alex Rodriguez, Giancarlo Stanton.
The pitch. Chris, and remember, Giancarlo Stanton won the 2016 Home Run Derby at Petco Park.
Yeah, he made that place look like a wiffle ball field.
Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout.
Now, that pitch wasn't even close to being a strike, and that just goes to show you how defensive hitters can become when they're up against an 0-2 count. You're just hoping for a mistake somewhere near the zone that you can get the bat to, but right there, he was clearly anxious. He was swinging when the ball left the hand.
Torres in the box now. No balls and a strike. And it's 1-1. Next offering is in for a strike. The 1-1 is fouled off. And here it comes. And another ball.
2-2.
And now 2-2. Swing and a miss, struck him out.
Oh, really went aggressive in with that slider. Good two-strike pitch right there. At worst-case scenario, it's weak contact in play. Exactly where he and the catcher wanted it.
And that one fouled off. And now the 0-1.
Oh, this guy's so comfortable hitting with two strikes. Even a good pitch early in the at-bat. If he's not ready to pull the trigger, he's not worried if he gets to an 0-2 count.
The 0-2. High fly ball lifted in the air right field. Renfro grabs it on the run. Yanks held in check. They lead this one, though, 5-1. Back in Anaheim, we and head to the bottom of the fifth. The so in now for the Angels, Eduardo Escobar. The pitch. And that skips in the dirt.
You know, these Angels need to bring up the quality of their bats and specifically their swings. Just one extra base hit for them, so they haven't exactly been hitting the ball gap to gap or out of the park. That makes it really difficult to generate runs.
Two and one now. Outside.
3-1.
The 3-1. Swung on, belted. Bader ranging back. Back some more. Feeling for the wall as he makes the catch.
Man, I love that route. The ball was smoked. He knew he had to get back to the track right away. Turned his back on the infield. Got to the spot, turned around, and made a nice catch.
Rengifo takes low, second trip to the plate in this one.
Now, there's a pitch we haven't seen in a while. It's going to be tough on the hitters if he can mix that in whenever he wants.
Righty to the plate. So, a foul ball makes it 1-2. In the air, fairly deep to right field. Brings it in. That's out number 2.
The shortstop, David Fletcher, next
to hit for the Angels. He reached on a walk his first time. Come on, Angels, there's a strike.
0-1.
Just that off the inside edge.
1-1.
Here's a 1-1. Popped up. Volpe should have this one. Makes the grab, and that'll end the inning. Angels held in check. They're down here 5-1. back here at Angel Stadium, top of the sixth inning. And stepping in for the Yankees, DJ LeMahieu. Davidson back to work. And that's in the dirt. Singy, DJ LeMahieu earned a pretty cool distinction when he won the American League batting title with the Yankees in 2020. He became the first player in the modern era to win a batting title in both leagues. Remember, he won with the Rockies the batting title in the National League in 2016. This one chopped on the ground, but foul. The pitch. Fouls one off. 2-2. Kicks and deals. Just off the outside edge.
Yeah, and when he won that title with the Rockies, a lot of people thought it was the Denver effect and just the amount of base hits that you can get in Coors Field, but he proved everyone wrong.
Ward makes the play, and there's one down.
The batter, the center fielder, Harrison Bader.
Stepping in, Harrison Bader. Singy, you got to appreciate a guy who's this good defensively. I mean, watching him track balls in the outfield, it is beautiful.
And I would say that most great defensive outfielders, it's kind of natural. There is some work that you can do to it to improve your game, but ultimately, you either have it or you don't.
And a base hit right there. So a man aboard now with one away.
Now everything was on time and fluid in that swing. Got a pitch you could get the barrel on and lined it into center for the knock. Those always feel good.
So man aboard. Now here is Billy McKinney. Step off, throw to first. Bader dives back.
There's one guy that I can think about, Boog, who started as a third baseman, Alex Gordon, and then became an elite perennial gold glover out in left field for the Kansas City Royals. But he's a guy, when you watch him play, you would imagine that that's all he ever played in his life was the outfield.
The pitch. Yeah, some guys just have instincts, right? I mean, that's the way it goes. We talk about Larry Walker, the Hall of Famer, and his instinct on the bases, despite the fact that he didn't play a ton of baseball as a kid. The 2-0 is in for a strike. I remember Mark Kotze, who was a real good defensive outfielder. Good instincts, not great speed. Bader runs. Swing and a miss. Bro, save. That's a stolen base.
Well, with a good arm behind the dish, it's definitely a roll of the dice here to try to steal second base. Man, he can zip it down there so quickly. That was a pretty good throw as well, but really good, clean, stolen base. He can be pretty proud of himself.
Runner on the go again. Next offering is foul back. Off the plate inside. 3-2 now.
Yeah, and I figured you would get Kotze into this because you had a free dinner at his house the other night.
That is true. Runner at second here, one gone. Looking for the K.
Man, he had the stanky leg on that one right there. That curveball just locked him up.
Jose. And here's the catcher, Jose Trevino.
RBI knock for him last time. Now a chance to drive in another run.
Runner at second, two down.
Wow, just a beautiful backdoor slider right there. If you've got any chance of hitting that pitch, you have to wait until the absolutely last millisecond.
No, that's a ball.
Just a tough pitch to hit and not an easy one to throw either.
The 1-1. Turned on, but foul wide of third.
All sliders so far in this at bat to get ahead in the count, and clearly shows there was a game plan in mind for how to attack him in the box.
And he swings and lifts one to deep center field. And that one's gone. All muscle to center field, and they boost their lead. It's 7-1.
And with the six-run lead, there are fans that are starting to head to the exits. Good hitter gets pitch recognition early. He saw exactly where that was going to be. The challenge, not get over anxious and come out of your swing. He stayed on it and got all of it.
So up next, Anthony Volpe. He's already homered in this game. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Volpe goes 5'9", just 21 years old. A former first-round pick back in 2019. The wind of the pitch. That one fouled off. Next pitch inside. And that's ball two. And a strike in there.
Back-to-back fastballs in. That last one called for a strike. Probably go away, but look for him to come back in there to try to finish you off.
And down on strikes he goes. And that is that. Two-run blast for the Yankees this inning. It's now 7-1. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. Bottom of the sixth inning, and now the center fielder, Mickey Moniak.
And leading off for the Angels, the center fielder.
Clearly down in this ball game, and you can't look at the deficit and try to get it all back in one swing. It's got to come one at bat at a time, and even shrink it down smaller, pitch to pitch. Make that guy on the mound work to get you out.
Movement in the Yankees pen, Albert Abreu getting loose out there for Aaron Boone. Pitch misses, one and one. Left-hand hitter waits. And a count, one and two. Got him. Down on strikes, and he knew it.
Well, that curveball had some pretty good break to it. As you can see, the hitter just locked up a little bit. Thought it was a great pitch to hit, but sometimes you're looking for something else, and you can't pull the trigger.
Ward at the plate now. That's ball one.
I can't play around with him here. It's a six-run lead at this point. Got to attack hitters, even if you give up a solo shot.
The wind to kick the 2-0. In the air, left side. And puts the squeeze on it. That's out number two.
Now batting, the designated hitter.
So now here's the DH, Shohei Ohtani. One for two. Pretty amazing athlete this guy is. Power and speed, quite a threat. I mean, you're talking about someone that could steal your bag and go deep. Bo Jackson, anyone?
One ball, no strike.
The wind to kick the pitch. That one to first. He takes it on his own. That ends the inning. So they go quietly there. Seventh inning coming up. It's the Yankees 7 and the Angels 1. Welcome back. Top of inning number 7. Here's the Yankees leadoff hitter, Isaiah Kiner-Falefa. And a pitch.
Yeah, he's like Mike Trout. You figure whatever you put in his hand, whether it's a bat, whether it's a golf club, whether it's a basketball, he can do it and get it done. And a rare talent, so much fun to watch.
And there's a foul ball. The next offering misses. 2-1. Bullpen activity starting up now. Jaime Barria up and throwing. Loop, a left-hander, also throwing. The count 2-1. There's a swing and a miss.
2-2.
Could see he was trying to stay back long enough to handle the off-speed pitch, but just a little tardy on the fastball.
And now the lefty on the ground, right side, on to Moustakas. That's the first out, the top of the seventh.
Well, a well-thrown slider like that one can be tough to get in the air. Good downward break on that one.
And now it's Giancarlo Stanton.
Struck out on just three pitches last time.
First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
0-1.
And the slider just misses.
Nasty backdoor slider. There's really nothing you can do with that if you swing at it, so that's a good take by him.
2-1.
That missed inside. Now two balls and a strike. And downstairs.
3-1.
The 3-1. Downstairs, and it misses ball four.
You know, I think he's okay with that outcome. It wasn't an intentional walk, but he wasn't exactly trying to attack the zone either.
Here comes Gleyber Torres. Hammered down the line. Could be extra bases. Stanton rounds second, heads for third. Lead runner holds at third, so two runners in scoring position and just one out.
Well, that started and ended pretty quickly. No messing around right there. It's always fun to see a double rip down the line. That one just barely stayed fair, so that was a good call by the umpire. He was all over it.
A new pitcher in the game, number 59.
And never an easy situation coming in with runners at second and third. He's got a base to work with, so he doesn't have to be perfect, but he does have to make some quality pitches.
Anthony Rizzo stepping in now for the Yankees. That one's in there, 0-1. Second and third here, one away. Swing and a miss, and it's 0-2.
Gosh, a little late on that breaking ball. I don't think he recognized it out of the hand, just a little tardy. Gonna have to regroup here.
Left-hand batter waits. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Some high cheese for strike three.
Boog gets talked about a lot, but a good high fastball in a two-strike situation, it's just become such a problem for hitters in more recent years. I mean, with all of the emphasis by pitchers on developing that spin rate, having a good grip on the baseball, those high fastballs, they kind of look like to the hitter that they're rising, even though they're not, but they're not decreasing in velocity and spin rate. So very difficult to get the barrel on it.
Two on, two outs. And a foul ball left side. Ball to strike in the air, right side. Renfroe getting an angle on it. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And that will end the inning. Yanks strand a pair. And they're on top 7-1. Back here at the ballpark. Now it's Hunter Renfro. And the right-hander back to work. This one high in the air to left center. Bader should have it. Hauls it in, and there's one away.
He was all over that first pitch fastball. Just barely missed it. Man, this guy was ready to hit.
And next for L.A., Mike Moustakas. That one clips the outside corner. Strike one. Missed inside with the curve. And he deals. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. The wind and the pitch. Fights that one away, still 1-2. Check swing, and he held up. Line drive. Tosses to first. Two up, two down.
Now batting. The catcher,
Matt Theis. Two outs, base is empty. Matt Theis digs in now. First offering in the dirt. Yeah. And that's in for a strike.
Boog, that hook's looking pretty sharp today. Just a solid pitching performance so far, and I really think it's because of that curveball.
That's the ball.
And that one is inside. Fouls one off. 2-2. Ground ball, Rizzo picks it up. He steps on the bag, and it's a 1-2-3 inning. This one pretty well decided at this point. We look ahead to inning number 8. It's the Yankees 7 and the Angels 1. And welcome back. We're at the top of the 8th, and stepping in for the Yankees, Harrison Bader. The right-hander back to work. There's a strike. And a pitch. Swing and a foul straight back. And the righty deals. Foul ball still 0-2. Line drive. And he pulls up on it, and that's a hit.
I'd say a mistake pitch in an 0-2 count. Too good of a pitch to hit now, right now, there. You have to expand the zone. Keep that leadoff man off first base.
Billy McKinney getting ready to hit. Yeah. at the belt and fires. That one way outside. One ball, one strike.
Oh, he's really working him away this at bat. Sometimes take a little bit off velocity. Try to get a rollover, something on the ground. Stay away from that big hole on the right side of the infield.
Pitch misses there. Two balls and a strike. Nobody out. Runner at first. Fought off foul. Two down. Good job to fight that one off. And the pitch in the air, right field. Renfro in position, hauls it in for the out.
Up next for the Yankees, the catcher, Jose Trevino.
Man at first, Jose Trevino stepping in now for the Yankees. He's already homered here in this one. And the first pitch misses for ball one. There's a strike. Right-handed reliever drilled out towards left center field. That's well struck. And that one is gone. Another homer. He's done it again. His second homer of the game. It's 9-1. Zingy, he's been red hot.
Yeah, another big swing of the bat for him. Man, he is really seeing the ball well in this one. Just an excellent swing all the way around, and it had that sound coming off the bat that gets everyone's attention. Got a pitch to drive, short to the baseball, squared it up, and the backspin carried it out of here.
So one out, nobody on. Anthony Volpe now at the plate. First pitch just misses. Still only one out here in the inning. The 1-0. And that one off the outside edge. And there's the strike.
2-1.
The pitch. And it's fouled away. Comes a 2-2. The punch out there, and he's down on strikes for the second time today. Back to the top of the Yankee order, Isaiah Kiner-Falefa will hit next. That's through there for a strike. The 0-1. And there's a ball.
1-1.
In the air out to center. Makes the grab, and that ends the inning. But two come across to score in the inning, courtesy of this two-run homer. And this is now a 9-1 ball game. Back now, new pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the eighth, Tommy Kahnle.
Compared to some days, this is a pretty low leverage appearance for him, so he should be fairly free and easy out there. Still have to keep yourself sharp and attack the strike zone.
And now it's switch hitting third baseman Eduardo Escobar.
Almost drove one out of here last time up, wide out to the warning track.
The pitch. In for a strike. It's 0-1. Action in the pen down there. Number 63, the lefty, looks to be getting himself ready. Righty delivers. A little bit low.
Just missed with that backdoor breaking ball. If he gets a swing and miss or called strike, 0-2 count. Instead, it's 1-1. Look for him to go back to that pitch later in this at bat.
Right-hander kicks, deals.
That's a ball.
On the ground. And it finds its way through for a hit. Man aboard on the leadoff single.
Showed some really nice patience in that at bat. Worked himself into a good count. We've all seen the defensive shift make a big difference in defending against pull hitters, but it's not foolproof. He pulled it as expected, but he found a hole that time.
Luis Rengifo, the next to hit for the Angels. First pitch, and he just misses.
Well, the leadoff man gets on. You want to minimize the threat by playing sound defense. Hopefully the pitcher can get a ball on the ground, and they can roll him up for two.
And here it comes. And it's even up.
It might be time to choke up a little bit, get that front foot down early, maybe even just spread out. He's really late right now.
And a 1-1. Swing and a miss. Nice changeup.
One ball, two strikes.
And now the count is even. Maybe a two ball. 5-4-3. And they turn the double play.
Well, he made his pitch down in the zone. He got that ball on the ground. The double play he was looking for. Really good execution.
Two outs. Bases empty. And next for the Angels, David Fletcher. Pitches in there, and it's 0-1. Two outs. Base knock right field.
Center fielder, number 16.
Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly.
Back to the top of the Angels lineup, Mickey Moniak, the next to hit for the Angels. Swing and a high fly ball to left. Connor Falefa pulls it down and he makes the catch. And that will end the inning. Angels leave one. They trail it big. It's 9-1. Back here at Angel Stadium, Giancarlo Stanton to the plate now.
Giancarlo Stanton.
The pitch off the mark there, and that's ball one.
One ball, no strike.
Inside, no, just missed.
Boog, he never moved because he never had time to. But that kind of velocity, you'd prefer that pitcher work away.
And the right-hander deals. That's off the mark. Three balls, no strikes. And a pitch. There's a strike.
3-0 hack right three there. See, man, I'm going to go for it.
The 3-1. 3-1, and he couldn't come up with it.
Well, a good day for the on-base percentage right there. Walk number three, and the free bags keep on coming. You down with OBP, Boo?
Here is Gleyber Torres. That's in for a strike.
There it was, a high velocity fastball in the zone. I think a little frustration from walking the previous hitter. He's got good stuff. Pitch inside the zone and trust it.
Yoan rolled softly, but that goes foul. That one misses, and that is ball one.
See how the catcher wanted that pitch up and in. Wanted to try to tie him up. That's the one thing we're seeing, that high fastball. You have to get it up there because of how hitters have changed their swings.
Next one is off the play. 2-2.
2-2.
Pitch goes down swinging for the strikeout. The high heat, too much on that one.
Not the best location with the fastball on strike three, but when you're pumping high 90s, you get away with some of those. More margin for error. You know, the fastball has become such a huge strikeout pitch in the sport, and I think a lot of it has to do with all the attention and emphasis on improved spin rates. These fastballs are just exploding out of the pitcher's hands and jumping through the zone.
Rizzo in the box with one away as he takes ball one. Good eye right there.
Two balls, no strikes.
Two and oh to Cal. Here it comes. There's the strike. That one inside. Three balls and a strike. Here comes a pitch. That one's in there, and it's 3-2.
Full count.
battling here as he fouls it away. Three, two now. That's foul off to the right side. Keeps the AB going. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Well, that's a nice job of grinding out that at bat. Saw a lot of pitches and ends up drawing the walk. Very gritty.
New pitcher in the game for the Angels, Jaime Barria.
I think it's got to be a little tough coming in out of the pen when your guys are trailing so big on the scoreboard. Just doesn't have the same intensity to it, but he's got to find a way because these batters count the same for his stats, obviously, regardless of the score.
Now it's LeMahieu up to hit. And when you talk about elite defensive third baseman, this guy is at the top of the list. First offering misses the mark.
This guy plays third base like he's a shortstop, and he welcomes the difficult play, can throw from so many different angles, and makes really tough plays look very easy.
And a foul ball. So what are the skills you look for that make a really good defensive third baseman that elite?
Well, Boog, one of the things I think about immediately are just the feet. Does he have good feet? Is he able to quickly react? And when you have good feet, you've got soft hands. And soft hand defenders are able to make tough plays look easy.
Swing and a miss for the strikeout. Slider got him for strike three. So first and second with two outs. Here's the center fielder, Harrison Bader. That one ripped way back there.
Foul ball.
And a pitch. Fouled off left side. First and second, two down. Oh, and two now. And a foul ball, he stays alive. Righty to the plate. Struck him out looking. Called strike three and a fastball up in the zone. Two left on. 2-3-4 set to hit in the bottom of the ninth. The Yankees 9 and the Angels 1. Back in Anaheim, last chance for the home team. So in now for the Angels, Taylor Ward. Canely back to work. And he grounds one to the right side. Throws to first, and they get the leadoff man in the ninth.
Now that the designated hitter, Shohei.
Shohei Ohtani, the next to hit for the Angels. 1-3. Canely, 6-1 righty. He features a changeup, a four-seamer, and he works in a slider. Movement in the bullpen. Ian Hamilton getting ready to go. The 1-0. And he flips a breaking ball in there or a changeup.
Either one. Something off speed. Good arm action on it. Whatever it was.
Swing and a miss. Now 1-2. And now 2-2.
Two balls, two strikes.
That one missed.
Ball count.
Three and two now. Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout. And, Chris, that's a way to neutralize his speed by keeping him off base.
And the defense breathes a sigh of relief because he puts pressure on everyone if he can put the ball in play. But that's how you do it. Keep him off balance, get him out of there, and deal with the next guy.
And first offering is fouled off.
Some real good life going through the zone on that one.
Top of the zone for a strike. 0-2 now. And now one and two.
I don't think he was trying to miss by that much in an 0-2 count. Just tried to overthrow that pitch.
That just misses, and the count is 2-2.
That turns out to be a really good take right there, but you don't want to end this game with the bat on your shoulder.
Just one strike away. That one hit to right. He's got it. Ball game. The Yankees slug their way to a win in this one.
Well, a big win by 8 runs, and when you have that kind of lead, do you make it easier for the pitching staff to come out, make their pitches, pitch to contact, and not worry about giving up the lead? So nice job today all the way around to get the W.
9-1 is how it ends. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew, I'm John Ciampi saying so long.
Our final line score tonight, first for the victorious Yankees, 9 runs, 11 hits, no errors.